Seoul, South Korea is a vibrant and intriguing metropolis that expertly combines historic architecture with cutting-edge technology. There are a ton of tourist attractions in the city, from interior activities like visiting one of Seoul's numerous museums to outdoor adventures like hiking Mount Namsan and the park around it. Seoul is a city of palaces as well, with five massive, beautifully renovated palace complexes dispersed around the city. First built in 1395, Gyeongbokgung Palace is the largest of Seoul's five grand palaces built during the powerful Joseon Dynasty. The National Palace Museum of Korea and the National Folk Museum of Korea are both located on the palace grounds and are both well worth a visit. Since the Palace Museum displays artifacts from Joseon Dynasty palaces, it is especially fascinating. This includes priceless antiques and works of art, as well as regular kitchen and cleaning supplies. In order to tell the story of the Korean people since prehistoric times, the National Folk Museum focuses on everyday objects, as well as clothing and dioramas. The largest and primary gate of Seoul's Gwangwomon neighborhood, Gwangwomon is where visitors enter Gyeongbokgung Palace. It is here that the daily ceremony of the changing of the guards takes place at 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. The gate had its most recent restoration and renovation in 2010, when it was relocated back to its original location and rebuilt using local building materials and customary construction techniques. From its commanding point atop Mount Namsan, the N-Seoul Tower rises around 500 meters above the city, providing stunning views of the city. The N-Seoul Tower features several gift shops in addition to five different dining options. Although the tower offers spectacular views, the city may also be seen from other locations. And with various themed lighting displays, the tower's outside computer-controlled LED lights provide a digital, visual cultural experience of Seoul. One of Seoul's newest sites is the skyscraper known as the Lotte World Tower. It is now the fifth highest building in the world, standing over 500 meters above the surface of the planet, and it is South Korea's highest building. The delicate curves of the vase-like shape are meant to evoke traditional Korean ceramic pieces. You should also visit the huge mall and the Lotte World Aquarium and Museum of Art, which are also there. The building houses the Lotte Concert Hall and the Lotte Cinema, a state-of-the-art 21-screen movieplex with the largest movie screen in the world. Behind the Deoksugung Palace lies a substantial collection of art known to the locals as Sima. The majority of the works are modern, which feature a wide variety of works and artists from across the world, although it mostly features Korean art and Korean artists. The collection is on display on three floors of a large structure that once served as the home of the Korean Supreme Court. There are also six more satellite locations spread out over Seoul that house the museum's major collections, rotating exhibits, in addition to the special exhibitions. And then the historic temple complex known as Jingwansa is located among the breathtaking scenery of the Bukhansan National Park and offers several opportunities to explore and learn about Buddhism and temple life. You can also reach these temples through the numerous hiking routes winding through the mountains surrounding the historic structures. The temples offer a variety of open activities and grows the majority of its own food. There are cultural and educational events, as well as a package for temple stays that includes an overnight visit. Additionally, they provide culinary experiences, including a typical vegetarian temple lunch consumed by monks. Thank you for watching. We hope this list has helped you in finding your next location to enjoy. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.